where the Smithsonian leads, other museums will follow, especially when it's free admission. Mark Siekman from the Kentucky Science Center joins us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning. How are
you? You have a new name.
We do. We're the State Science Center of Kentucky, and we're living up to it.
How have things changed in any way?
We've got a lot of great partnerships across the board. We're offering a lot of free, exciting activities this fall, starting with Saturday, September 29th, as part of our partnership with the Smithsonian. Their event, Smithsonian Museum Day Live. If you go to smithsonian.com/museumdaylive, you can sign up for free admission to the Science Center and nearly 2,000 other organizations nationwide.
So you're talking about free admission. How do we get our tickets?
You go to smithsonian.com/museumdaylive. You sign up there and you print off a receipt to bring to the admissions desk. It's good for you and one guest per email. So if you've got a couple emails, you can certainly bring more than two people to the Science Center.
What is the admission for adults or kids usually?
Admission is normally $13 for adults and $11 for children ages 2 to 12. Members are free. We have a great membership program, and you also get discounts in the shop and on IMAX tickets as well.
Big saving. Okay. I love any type of building block. So talk about what's going on for kids.
These are Kapla blocks. So this is part of one of the many things in our exhibit, Science and Play. It's custom designed for children ages 7 and younger to build on.
That's
learning, learning early science themes through play and experiments. This is part of the small build, so kids like to build these up, knock them down, start all over. It's great for what we kind of call the itty-bitties, the 4 and younger crowd. And we have a lot of other building areas. The big build, if you can kind of picture Legos on steroids.
Ooh,
build
that
to
sounds
the sky,
fun. Yeah.
Knock it over, same kind of concept. You can build your own roller coaster. We have a shapes and stuff store.
That's big stuff.
Absolutely. And we have this great little concept called Airways, where it's a bunch of pipes going a million different directions. You can stick a scarf or a ball in it and watch it shoot around and then pop out the top. And it's great fun.
Wow, kids can stay all day.
All day. And actually, the first Tuesday and the first Saturday of the month, we're offering something new we're doing called play dates. So starting at 8:30 a.m. until 9:30 a.m., children four and younger and their caregivers, completely free playtime inside Science and Play.
Another free event. And I see the big noodles behind us. Talk about that. That's so much fun.
So this is part of what you experience when you first walk into Science and Play. It's the sensory course, and this is part of the noodle forest. We've kind of made a mini one. But in the actual noodle forest, picture hundreds of these that you can run through, bang around.
Yeah.
You know, you're not going to hit your head on anything sharp or anything, but kids just have a blast running back and forth.
Oh, wow. And I know the Science Center is also moving outside.
We are. We have a great partnership with the Parklands of Floyd Fork. So on October 7th, a Saturday, we're offering our first annual Harvest Festival. So you can follow us on the website at louisvillescience.org for directions and more information. It's a great outdoor event. You can learn how crops are harvested. You can learn why leaves change, take walks throughout the creeks, and kind of explore.
Lots more.
Yeah.
Free pumpkins.
Absolutely. Free pumpkins to decorate for the first 200 visitors. It's kind of taking science outdoors. We can do a lot within our walls, but we want to take it out in the community.
Sounds all like good fun.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Hey, it's fun to be a kid again, especially when it's free. Now that's the real deal. Go Rabbits!